Next is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 6th chapter, text 4 through 9, given by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in September of 1966 in New York.
Yada hi indriyatheshu na karmasu anusajyate sarva sankalpa sanyasi yugarudha sadasyate ऊर्धरीतात्मनात्मानम् नात्मानम् अवसादयत् आत्मैवाध्यात्मनो बन्धुर् आत्मैवरिकुलात्मनम्. Now these two shlokas that we were discussing last week, that we have to raise ourselves to the spiritual standard by ourselves. I have to raise myself to the spiritual standard by myself. So I am my friend and I am my enemy. This is the opportunity. There is a very nice verse in Chanakya Pandit. Nakaschit kasyachit mitram, nakaschit kasyachit ripu, davahareva jayante mitrani vivastaka. Nobody is nobody's friend, nobody is nobody's enemy, but it is only the behavior by which one can understand who is his friend and who is his enemy. Nobody is born enemy, nobody is born friend, but by our mutual behavior, somebody is my friend and somebody is my enemy. Similarly, as we have this dealing in the ordinary daily affairs, similarly, I have my dealing with myself. But if I deal with me, myself, as friend, then I am my friend. And if I deal with myself enemically, then what is that friendship and enemical? The friendship is that I am so somehow or other have been in contact with this material nature. So I have to get myself out of the entanglement of this material nature. If I act in that way, then I am my friend. But even after getting this opportunity, if I do not act in that way, then I am my enemy. So, ātmai va dhātmano bandhu, rātmai va dhātmano ripu. So I am myself friend, my friend, and I am my enemy. Bandhurātma ātmanastasya jīnaiva ātmanā jita. अनात्मनस्तु शत्रुते वर्तता आत्मैव शत्रुवत्. Now, how I can become my friend? That is explained here. That bandhur atma atmana tasya. Atma means mind. Atma means body and atma means soul. That these three things I have already explained the other day. That's when you speak of Atma or Self, just as so long I have got my bodily construction, when I say myself, I think of my body. When I transcend the bodily construction of life, then I think I am mine. But actually, when I am in this real spiritual platform, then myself means I am pure spirit. So according to the state of development, my conception of self are different. So far, Nirukta or dictionary is concerned, body, mind and the spirit, soul, everything is called self. Now here it is called Bandhur Atma Atmanasasya. Now, here, one Atma is meant mind. Mind is the friend of oneself, and mind is the enemy of one. So you have to train the mind. If I train my mind for becoming my friend, then my life is successful. If I train my mind to become my enemy, then my life is unsuccessful. Anatmanastu satrutte bhattita atmaiva satruva. But one who has no knowledge of the spiritual self, then his mind acts like his enemy. One who has got the conception of this body as myself, his mind is his enemy. And one who has got the conception of the spirit self, his mind is his friend. So mind has nothing to do. Mind simply training of the mind requires. And how the mind is trained? It is by good association. Good association, our mind is trained. Sangha sanjayate kama. Kama means desire. Desire is the function of the mind. And sangha sanjayate kama. And according to the association, my mind desires like that. So we have to make good association. If we want to make our mind as my friend, if I want to make my friend as my mind as my friend, then I have to associate with sadhu. Tasmat sasu sadhita buddhiman. Buddhiman means intelligent person. He must associate with satsu. Satsu means those who are trying for self-realization. They are called sat. Sat and asat. Asat means they are trying for the temporary things. Matter is temporary. My body is temporary. So if I simply engage myself for bodily pleasure, sense gratification, then I am engaging myself to temporary things. But if I engage myself for self-realization, the permanent thing, then I am engaging myself to the sat or to the permanent. So tasmat satsu sajjeta buddhiman, anyone who is intelligent, he should associate with persons who are trying to elevate themselves for self-realization. That is called satsang, good attitude. And what is the result of good association? Now, because if we make good association, the santa chinnanti, santa means the persons who are sadhu, who are pious, they can cut off by their words our attachment to this material. They can cut off, just like Krishna is speaking to Arjuna. What is the idea of speaking so many things? Just to cut off his attachment from the so-called material affection. He is affected with something which is stumbling his progress in his own duty. So Krishna is presenting his Bhagavad Gita just to cut off. Santa eva hi chindanti uktihi. Chindanti means cut. Now, for cutting something, we require some certain instrument. But here, to cut off the mind from attachment, it requires sharpen ukti. Ukti means word. Sharpen topic. There should not be just like when a person cut something, there is no mercy. Similarly, when a sadhu or a person speaks to his friend, to his student, he does not make so any mercy. He speaks the truth so that his mind may be cut off from the unreal attachment. Just like Krishna is saying. Krishna, Arjuna, first addressed to Arjuna. He says, Asasyanam sujastam prajnavadam suhasam. Oh, you are talking like a fool, you are talking like a very learned man, but you are fool number one. You see, how strong word you have used. So far, if we want detachment from this material world, then we should be prepared to accept that cutting word from the master. Sanda asat sindanti uttihi uttihi. We should not make compromise. So don't speak such strong words. It is required. So bandhana anatmana sushatrute bhatteta atmaiva sattva. Anatma. Those who have no self-realization, his mind, one who has not realized his what he is. We are generally conception of this bodily conception of our life. But the intelligent person who has made association with a saintly person, he can understand that I am not this body. And the material conception of life is condemned in so many places. Jasnātma buddhi punapetri dhātake sadhit kalatrādiṣu bhomai jadhi jatvīrtha buddhi sarile. In so many ways. The one who has got the conception of his personal self with this body made of three elements, one who thinks that the land in which he is born or the relatives who is connected with this body, they are all everything. Then that man is no better than ass and cow, it is said like that. So we should have, by good association, by study of good books like Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, we should realize ourselves. Otherwise, our mind will remain always an enemy. And enemy, as the enemy is always prepared to do harm, so my mind will drag me to things which will make me entangled more and more in this material, miserable life. Manasasthani indriyani prakitisthani karsati. We are struggling very hard with this mind and sixth sense. So we have to make the mind our friend. Now Krishna is gradually making progress to explain to Arjuna how the mind can be made friend. Jītātmana prasāntasya paramātmā samāhitaḥ śītoṣṇa sukha-dukkheṣu tathāmānā pumānaya jñāna-vijñāna-cittyātmā kutastha vidyateṇdriya yuktā yuktuccate yogī samādustrāśma-kāñcana. Now, by training the mind, jītātmana, one who has conquered over the mind, jītātmana, prasāntasya. Prashant means he has become in equilibrium. Prashant. Prashant, because mind is dragging me always in non-permanency. Harāva bhaktasya kuto mahaguna manorathena asato dhāvatvahi asato manorathena. By the chariot of the mind, so long we are seated on the chariot of the untrained mind, unbridled mind. The mind will drag me to things which are non-permanent. But my whole business is that I am permanent, I am eternal. Somehow or other, I have got this attachment for non-permanent things, so I have to get out of this entanglement. So if my mind is not trained up, then the mind's business will be to drag me to non-permanency. Harāva bhaktasya kuto mahaguna. But this mind, as I told you the other day, can be very easily trained up if we fix up in our mind, on the fort of the mind, a great soldier, Krishna. Just like if the fort is defended by a great general, then there is no question of entering of the enemies. Similarly, if we put Krishna on the fort of the mind, then there is no chance of entering on the enemy. Savai manat krishna padaravinda, that day we have explained. And if we do not do that, haravu hattasya kuto mahadguna. Mahadguna means the material acquisition, material education, material wealth, or so many material qualifications. That will not help me to control my mind. That is not possible. Only thing that if I put on the mind Krishna as God, Harabha, Krishna consciousness, then my mind will be very easily calm. So, Jita Atmana Prashantas. Prashanta means who has ceased to desire material enjoyment. Bhavantameva charan nirantaram prashanta nishtesha manorathantaram. A devotee is praying to the Lord. Bhavantameva charan nirantaram. When I shall be able to act 24 hours in your service, or when I shall be able to think of you 10%, and prashanta nishtesha manorathantaram. Manorathantaram means mind is dragging me in so many imaginations, so many plan-making business. We have got so many plan-making business. That is called manorathantaram. Just like I go on some chariot, on some car, in several places. The mind is, the same thing is described, maya jantra ruhena maya. So we are traveling like that. That way. But as soon as I am able to fix my mind on the lotus feet of Krishna in Krishna consciousness, it becomes Jita Atman. Jita Atman is Tanta. And then my mind becomes clear of all these engagements as non permanent, prashantasya. Jita Atman prashantasya paramatma samahita. That is possible. Paramatma means super soul. We have several times told you that Paramatma is with me. The same thing. Paramatma is sitting with me in the heart. I, the soul, the atomic part, spirit part, that is also in the heart. And side by side, in the similar, the smallest way, the Supreme Lord is also with me. Paramatma samahita. This Paramatma samahita is the yoga. Now, Krishna will gradually come, Paramatma. The yoga system is, meditation means to control all the senses and concentrate the mind to focus on the Paramatma. That is the whole yoga system. So here it is hinted, Paramatma samadhita, completely absorbed in the Paramatma. Prashanta. Prashanta means cease from all non-permanent activities. And jitātmana. Jitātmana means conquered by the senses. So jitātmana prashantasya paramatma samadhita, sitosna sukadikhesu, tathamana pamanaya. Sitosna sukadikhesu. Duality. Duality. We have got in this material world duality. Just like this is now summer season. And then again we'll have winter season, snowfall. Sita usna. Sita means winter season. And usna means summer season. Sitosna sukadikhesu. Similarly, happiness and distress. Happiness and distress, tatha mana pumanaya, similarly honor and dishonor. Because in this world of duality, dual world, everything is to be understood by duality. We cannot understand what is honor if there is no dishonor. If I am not insulted, I cannot understand what is honor. Mana pumanaya, similarly, I cannot understand what is misery if I am not tasted happiness. But I cannot understand what is happiness if I have not understood misery. So similarly, I cannot understand what is cold if I have not tasted hot. With this world is a duality. So one has to transcend. So long this body is there, this duality feeling will continue. So because I am trying to get out of this body, bodily conception, not exactly out of the body, but bodily conception, so I'll have to practice to tolerate this duality. As in the second chapter where Krishna has advised Arjuna, this duality of distress and happiness, this is due to the skin. This is skin disease. Just like eating of the skin. So, because there is eating, I should not be mad after it. I should tolerate. There are so many. So nowadays mosquito bite is going on. So, we should not be mad. We should not give up our duty because mosquito is biting. Or some big bug is biting. So many dualities that we have to tolerate. So, if my mind is always in Krishna consciousness, then these dualities can be practiced very easily. Sitosna Sutada Sada. Jnana-vijnana trityatma kutastha vijitendriya. Why he will be able to understand, to tolerate? Because jnana-vijnana-trityatma. Jnana means knowledge. Theoretical knowledge is called jnana. And practical knowledge is called vijnana. Just like a science student has to study theoretical and appear theoretical examination as well as practical examination. If a science student has to pass his examination, then he has to practice simply theoretical knowledge that so much quantity of hydrogen and so much quantity of oxygen will make water will not may help him. He has to practically show in the laboratory that so much quantity of oxygen gas and so much quantity of hydrogen gas mix and water is produced. That is called vijnana. Jnana-vijnana, vidyasthana. One should have not only theoretical knowledge, but practical knowledge. Practical knowledge. Simply understanding that I am not this body, I am not this body, then I am doing all nonsense of this body. I am discussing. And there are so many societies. They are very seriously discussing Vedanta philosophy. Smoking with wine glass and very enjoying life, you see. So that sort of jnana, that sort of knowledge is not necessary, you see. So, jnana vijnana, one should have knowledge perfectly and it must be demonstrated in practical sense. Yes. But that means one who has actually felt himself that I am not this body. Then naturally his bodily necessities will be reduced to the minimum. Will be reduced to the minimum. That is practical. If I am going to increase the demand from my body and I am simply theoretical thing that I am not this body, that is not required. Jnana-vijnana-pratisthapana. And then a person will be satisfied when there is jnana, knowledge and science side by side. Jnana, vijnana, practical. Kutastha, vijita, indriya. Then he conquered over the senses. Jnana, vijnana, vijita, kutastha, vijita, indriya. Jukta, ituchyate, yogi, samalusrasma, sanchana. So, when he is situated in that practical status, of spiritual realization, then he is to be understood that he is actually situated in the yoga. Not that I am going to a class and weekly or twice weekly attending yoga class and I remain the same thing for the so many years. No, there should be practical realization. What is that practical realization? Prasantatma, prasantatma. The mind is calm and quiet. No more agitated by the attraction of this material entanglement. So, jnana vijnatam kutastha viditam. And this is the first qualification, this qualification is self-control. Advancement in the yoga system means yoga indriya samyama. Yoga means to, because our whole life is disturbed due to this sense. And this material life is sense-getting. The common substance of materialistic life means sense-getting. Therefore, advancement of material science means giving you products for your sense gratification. Unnecessarily, so many things are produced just to satisfy my sense. That is material advancement. The material life means sense gratification and spiritual life means detached from sense gratification. So this is the end. Jitta yuktuchati yogi samalokatmakansha. And when he is in that position, equilibrium, then for him, samalostrasma kanchana, kanchana means gold, and lostra means, rubbles of stone, they are the same thing. So, samalostrasma kanchana. And again, suhin mitra durasinam madhasta desa mandusu sadhusapita papesu samabuddhi vishishati. We have got our relationship in this world. We call that he is my friend. Sweet and mitra. There are two kinds of friends. Sweet means better friend. Actually, who is always desiring my welfare. He is called sweet. And friend means, we have got goodwill, ordinary friend. Friend, mitra, udasina. Udasina means neutral, neither friend nor enemy. We have got relationship within this world. Somebody is my very good well-wisher, somebody is my friend, and somebody is neither friend nor enemy. And somebody madhyastha, mediator, and somebody doing some good. Somebody I think, here is a nice gentleman, saintly person. And somebody I think, here is a sinful man. According to my calculation, somebody my friend, somebody my enemy, somebody neutral, somebody, a saintly person, somebody sinful person. Now all this, when you are on the yoga-yukta, when you are in the platform of transcendence, then these distinctions, this friend, enemy, sadhu, saintly, and sinful, that is all disclosed. No. Pandita samadarsha. Pandita, when one becomes actually learned, he does not see any enemy or any friend. Because nobody is enemy, nobody is friend. Nobody is my son, nobody is my mother, nobody is... We are all different living entities. We are just playing on the platform under the grace of father, mother, wife, children, friend, enemy, just like in a drama. We set up some character to play. So, but out of this stage, we are all friends. Nobody. In this stage, I say, you are enemy, I shall kill you, and so many things I do. But when out of this stage, we are all friends. Similarly, in this world, in this material world, with this dress of material body, we are playing on the stage of material world, that enemy and friend and father, mother, son, I cannot beget any son. It is not possible.
Oh.
I simply beget this body.
You see?
The living entity, that is not my power.
Oh.
Simply by my sex intercourse with my wife, I cannot produce unless that living entity is blessed in that emancipation of true Sri Krishna. These are stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam. So this is only stage play. So actually, when one is situated in proper knowledge, one who is actually a yogi, for him, this distinction altogether different.
Yogi jungita satata atmanam rahasisthita.
Now here is the beginning of the yoga system, how one should perform yoga. Now you will understand from the description of Bhagavad Gita that what is yoga system. In your city, New York City, yoga is very popular. Everyone is performing yoga. There are so many groups of yoga schools. But just see what the yoga system is, you can understand from Bhagavad Gita. What is that? The first is, yogi junjita satatam atmanam rahasisthita. The yogi's business is always to remain alone in a secluded place. Alone and secluded place. Yoga cannot be performed in assembly. Just like we are in assembly. You are performing yoga, I am performing yoga in the yoga class, and somebody is teaching, do like this, do like that, do like that. That is not yoga. At least according to Bhagavad Gita. Here it is clearly said that yogi junjita satatam atmanam rahasisthita. He should always be engaged in focusing his mind towards the Paramatma. And that is possible. Rahasi. Rahasi means in a secluded place. It is not, I cannot concentrate my mind in the hubble bubble of the society or in the big city. The yoga system is fine. There are all the yogis formally. Still, in India, there are many yogis. They come at Kumbh Mela. We have seen some of them. Some of them are 700 years old. And you'll see him just like a boy of 25 years. They are doing some yoga. So they come when there is some special function. In India, there are four places, just like in modern days, there are conferences of different parties. Similarly, in India, there are still about 30,000 of saintly persons, not one, two. Major portion of them, they meet together after 12 years and in some particular place. There are four places. One at Prayag. You have heard the name of Allahabad city. That is called Prayag. And one at Haridwar and at Sankhar. In this way, they have got four places. That means every 4 years they are meeting. So in that meeting, many yogis come. When not in my renounced order, when I was living for some time at Allahabad, not some time, I lived there for 13 years at Allahabad. So I was seeing this mela. Although it was taking every 12 years, I have seen twice or thrice. These yogis, they are so calm and quiet. And looking,
some, of course I do not know, somebody says this man is 700 years old, this man is 300 years old, but they look like young boys. So these such yogis, as it is, recommended here, yogi jindita satatam atmanam, one who is actually ascended on the yogic principle, he is, first function is that he remains alone. He has no society. He cannot remain in society. Yogi jindita satatam rahasisthita ekaki. Ekaki means alone. It's more clearly to say, ekaki. Jata chittatma nirasi ra paribhaha. Nirasi, there is no expectation that by functioning yoga I shall achieve this power, and aparigraha, and he does not take anything from anybody. Who is going to give you? He is at ekaki, he is alone in a secluded place, in sometimes in jungle, in forest, in mountain, and who is going to give him anything? He doesn't expect, because he is, he's firmly convinced that for whom I have become yogi, I am not alone. My Paramatma is always with me. He is a yogi, unless what kind of yogi? He, although he remains superficially alone, but he knows that wherever I go, my Paramatma friend, he is sitting with me on my heart, he is with me. So I am nothing to fear. So I am nothing to fear. Yata chittatma, ekaki, yata chittatma nirashira parigraha. He does not accept anything for anything. Now just see the yogi principle for this age, how much it is difficult for us. If we want to perform real yoga system, then it is very difficult. Nobody, we are sitting here, so many ladies and gentlemen, is it possible for us to live alone in a secluded place in a mountain? We are not in the outside, we are near a city. There are so many mountains and jungles. Can you live there alone? Oh? No. At the present moment, the modern way of our civilization, a mode of our life, just that, I am a sannyasi. I am renounced at order of life, but still I have come to a city, New York City, the largest city of the world. From Bombay city or Calcutta city I have come. So life has become so changed that in this age, actually what is called yoga, it is not possible. It's not. First condition is that ekaki jatachittatma. So he should remain alone. He should perform yoga system alone, not in with friends and many other yogis, no. Jagatisnapa nirasira parigraha, and he should have no desire in his mind, and aparigraha, he does not want anything from anybody. This is the first condition. The next condition, suchau deshe pratishthapa siram asana matmanaha. Nastu chitam nasu nijam chila jina kusottaram. The yogi has to fix up his sitting place. What is that? Sucho desi. He should select a place which is very, very pure. Now that means a place like Haridwar or young friend, Mr. Howard, he has been to Haridwar, he has seen how nicely that place is. River Ganges is flowing and very nice, calm and quiet. He'll find 3 miles after, 4 miles after, one yogi is sitting nicely there and meditating. That is yogi. So, suchode, in a place, where they sanctified them. So these places are especially selected, just like Haridwar, Kankhal, and Prayag. They are from time immemorial, and in Vedic age, those places are sanctified. Just like this Bhagavad Gita was spoken in the battlefield of Kurukshetra, Dharma Kshetra, the land of religion. Even war was performed because this was not ordinary war. That was religious. Religious. This Kurukshetra battle, that was religious. Don't you find in the war field where Sri Krishna, the Supreme Personality of God, is present? Do you think it is ordinary war? No. It is not ordinary war. And it was performed in a place which is called Dharma Kshetra. So sometimes war is also performed in terms of religious. That is prescribed and it is required. So here, Suchaudesh, perfectly sanctified place. Suchaudesh is Pratishthapa. He must be situated in a very sanctified place, Thiram Asanam Atmana. And the asanam and the sitting place should not be same. On the same asana, he should perform yoga, meditation, on the same place and the same sitting place. Atmana, how that place, the sitting place should be selected, na hoti uchitam. Not too much raised, not too much low, not niche. And chila jina kusatram. Chila means cotton something, cotton sitting place. Then skin, dear skin means, you know, yogi is a seat on the skin of tiger and skin of deer. Why? Because they are in a secluded place. This has got some chemical effect. If you sit on tiger skin and deer skin, then the reptiles, the snakes, they won't disturb. It has got some, physical effect. There are so many medical effects in so many things we do not know. But God has created everything. For our use, we do not know that every plant, every herb is a medicine. It is meant for some particular disease, for some particular protection. We do not know that. So chila jina, it is not a fashion. It is because they sit down in a secluded place in a jungle, so you are meditating, so some snake may come. There are so many snakes, so many reptiles. So therefore, chela, jina, susattaram, and straw. So three things. Straw, and the skin, and some cotton, asan. These things are required. Then, what is the next process? The next process is tatraikagam manakritta jatasi tindriyakriya upavishya asane junjyat yoga atma visiddhaye. Atma Visuddhaya, the whole process is, yoga system is for purifying Atma. Purifying Atma, you always remember, the Atma means this body, Atma means the mind, Atma means the soul. So purify, these things. The yoga system is meant not that cheaply I want some power. Sometimes the yogi is achieving very wonderful power. Asya-siddhi yoga. Asya-siddhi any kinds of perfection, material perfection they can attain. Not for that purpose, yoga, although they attain that power. Real yogi, they do not exhibit. They do not exhibit. He has got the power, so many wonderful powers, but he's only aim is Atma-visuddhaya. I am now contaminated by this material atmosphere, so I have to purify myself. But that purification process we shall discuss next day. But I may say in this connection that so much physical process for purifying the Atma is very easily done. Teta Dhatmana Marjanam by chanting with Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram. Because the sound, this transcendental sound vibration, is non-different from Krishna. Krishna is absolute. His name is not different from Him. So when you chant His name with devotion, that means Krishna is with you. And Krishna, when Krishna is with you, how you can remain impure? You become pure, the pure. That is the whole system.